This is it. Evil Empire versus Disney World Order.
On the first page of our story, the future seemed so bright. Then this thing turned out so evil. Don't know why I'm still surprised. Even angels have their wicked schemes, and you take them.
A happy place, full of love, laughter, and death.
Haha! Who do you think was behind this whole thing? Haha! I just want to let you know, I own Marvel, I own Star Wars, welcome to the Disney World Order, motherfuckers! Haha!
Turn your back on the NCAA galaxy like this!
We run the world! We're going to rule the world! We're the Disney World Order, motherfuckers! Who's gonna stop us?
Every sun is getting more bleak, a fresh poison each week. We were born sick, you heard them say it. My church offers no absolute. She tells me worship in the bedroom. The only heaven I've been sent to, it's when I'm alone with you. I was born sick, but I love it. Come at me to be well. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Take me to church. I'll worship like a dog. I just want to unite. I'll tell you my sins and you can drop in your night. Offer me that death and death to come. Let me give you my life. Take me to church. I'll worship like a dog.
Never.
To ignore the facts of history and the aggressive impulses of an evil empire.
Kind of reminds me of Freddy versus Jason. You don't know who is going to win. You have people that, you know, had their predictions.
I just see the king walking down the street. You need to bow down. Get off your feet.
but we all know who the loser is going to be. The fans and the rest of the NCAA roster. I'm confident to say that these two teams will destroy the Kaw world. Not alone the NCAA. I mean, five out of six of the contenders tonight are former world champions. A current hardcore champion, M. Bison. The current NCAA champion, Superman Prime. And the NCAA tag team champions, The Force, all in one match. Some would say that the Evil Empire is the less of evils. But at least they were homebred. They don't have a mouse tag on them. They should, though. I mean, it's only a matter of time before Disney buys DC anyway. And wouldn't M. Bison and Sinestro like a reboot? Come on. Let's face facts here. Disney can make that happen. And what about a Superman Prime movie? Did you guys see Superman vs. Batman? I'm going to give you a little bit of spoilers here, so don't listen to me 5 seconds after this. Okay, ready? Here goes the spoilers. Doomsday kills Superman. If Superman Prime was in there, he would kill him to death. And of course, Cade Skywalker has done his fair share of killing. He murdered, shot Jimmy McElroy, Captain America style. Didn't shoot him face to face, but from a balcony. I admire that shot. I mean, he was a man about it. He stepped up and said, "Hey, I killed Jimmy." You know, just not a lot of people know this, but we had an investigation by the police. And you know what they said? They didn't think this was real. Go figure. That's the last time I called Matt on one. Yes! No! Bison says yes, Anakin says no. Sidekick by Anakin. Definitely the powerhouse of this match. If you've seen him in tag team action, he is one half of the tag team champions and a dominant force of the team. He went to war with Superman Prime on the last Nitro. Chairs were used, blood was spilled, and what pisses me off is there wasn't a conclusive ending, because both teams had to interfere. And a tag by Superman Prime. You know, these guys just know each other so well. And I think that kind of favors the Evil Empire, because they've been partners for a good, what, 4 or 5 years now? The Force has only been together about 2. Of course, they are family, though. I mean, who can forget Kaw Cade 3? Where Cade Skywalker came down and Kaw Sky Gardner, the NCAA title, Swing Blade. We're going to call that the lightsaber. It sounds better. And Bison has been on a nice hot streak. He's been defending his hardcore title and not even one count. He was even forced to fight his own tag team partner, Superman Prime, for the NCAA title. So the man is still tough. As for Luke Skywalker, yeah, a little bitch. I'm sorry. Once Justin gets out of the hospital, you can even ask him, hey, what do you think of Luke Skywalker? He calls him a little bitch. The one thing we agree on. It's a good thing the Koala Man is not here right now. Because we have kind of a difference of opinion about this match. He thinks the Evil Empire is going to win. I think the Disney World Order is going to win. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm a Disney guy. I would rather be a pet than cattle. So I don't want to hear any comments, okay? I don't want you to choose a sellout. Swinging neckbreaker by Bison. Or on Bison. But whether you know it or not, Disney owns you. Okay, here's a question for you. Who paid money to go see Star Wars last year? Huh? Hands? You're owned by Disney. And one, two count. Do you find yourself singing, "It's a Small World After All"? You are owned by Disney. When you're 5-year-old, wait, Kate's going for a pin. Completely legal. One, two, three. Bison has been eliminated. When your 5-year-old says, "Hey, can you put on Frozen?" You're officially owned by the mouse. So I don't want to hear it from anyone saying, "Oh, well, Disney's the evil corporation." When they have kept your kids occupied with the Disney Channel, they have produced great movies. Who saw Civil War? Marvel, owned by Disney. Do you see a pattern here? So support the evil the Disney World Order. Show them some respect. Wait, Sinestro's going for a pin. One, two, kick out by Cade. And just really think about it. What have you done for Disney today? And in comes Luke. You know, there's a reason why there's no Evil Empire store in the mall. There's a Disney shop in the mall. One. Only one count. And Cade Skywalker is the only man on his team without championship gold. And what the hell did Luke just do? It was like a glitch. I'm sorry. But Cade's going to be wanting to rectify that next month at Blackest Night. Only on CPV. When he takes on Superman Prime. Which he earned that right to face Superman Prime. He won a number one contenders match. And he won that right fairly. Look at the promo. At the beginning of this chapter. It's proof he was bloody. He came off that ladder. 1, 2, 3, new number one contender. If it wasn't for the bad blood and twist of evil by Sinestro, Luke's going to kick out of this. Kick out. One, two, he'll kick out. Luke, you're a bitch. Luke has been eliminated. Power bomb. One, two, only a two count. And these two had a war last month too on plus one. One, two. You know, the Tokyo Dome has never experienced this much action. Slammed by Sinestro. It was actually at the first Blackest Night that these two fought for the NCAA title. Two. No, it kicks out. So yeah, mark your calendar. Last Sunday of June. Blackest night. Oh, steel chair shot. The referee didn't see it. He cheated. You pig fucker. I hate you. He's got him. And Cave breaks up. That's the move he does. And the referee just takes the steel chair out. Finally, he does his job. He's got Sinestro up. What's he going for? One of that trademark moves he does. Superplex to the outside on that steel ground, whatever that's made of. Aluminum foil, I can assure you. What's he going for? Pile driver. We've had enough pile drivers on the outside for one night. But no, no. Get back on the ring, Blackest Night. That's not until next month. I wonder what Sinestro's doing next month for, quote-unquote, his CPV. Another one. Oh, on the big man, he's bluffing. Don't tell me he's taking a count-out victory. That's cheap. And Kate's defending his family member. Yeah. It's on between Prime and Cade Skywalker and sidekick to the referee. But that totally backfired on Cade. Come on, Cade. Get up, boy. Get up.
Yeah, is here. The game is over.
Guy Gardner, he's back. Steel chair shot.
No more pretending.
And the referee has ruled this a double disqualification. Guy Gardner with that steel chair. Oh, he's been out for a few months. And one again to Cade Skywalker. He just ruined a great match. Oh, I hope you're happy, Guy. I hope you got your revenge. Just check out the Blackest Night main event. Fuck.